my image of Bach is not at all of this sort of person thinking, you know, I'm the greatest. Certainly he had his own personality quirks and he was irascible and all the rest of it. But I think the clue for me is the fact that he was so passionately interested in what other people were doing. I mean, he obviously knew he had gifts and believed in himself, but I don't think he ever would have had I don't think he had time to think about that, frankly. I think it was only in the last decade of his life when, you know, he'd written complete cycles of church cantatas, 300 cantatas, he'd written all the St. Matthew, the St. Mark, the St. John, and so on, that he wanted to just kind of work on things that were meaningful to him. So you can look at any of the pieces in that decade, whether it's the Klavierübung ending with the Goldberg variations, the musical offering, the canonic variations, the Art of Fugue, and the B minor Mass, as works that were very close to his heart. And, you know, what his mind was at the time, I'm sure it was anything but boastful. I think it was an urgent need to leave his musical last will and testament on these various forms. It's miraculous, really. It reminds me of it was a criticism they used to make in church that Bach was confusing the congregation with his introduction or even accompaniment of hymns by inserting all of these strange harmonies and things of that sort. What I find so revealing is when we have the choir sing these chorales, some of which are familiar to us even today, and then you hear how Bach takes off vamps, if you will, on this melody in the most unbelievable ways. You could put yourself back in that time and say, what is he doing? Where is he going with all of this? And then all of a sudden there's a melody clear as day. I have to do it. I mean, I'd go crazy if I couldn't still perform as long as I'm able to perform. I mean, we've often used this term irrepressible urge, which is how the Bach concert got started, but performing's very fundamental to my life. I don't want to say a selfish preoccupation, but somehow I try as best I can to balance all the other responsibilities with opportunities to perform. I love to think of the demographics in general, not only in our audience, but in our performers. They come from, as you can imagine, a vast field of personal beliefs or no beliefs or Christian or Jewish or Muslim or what. Yeah, I think it is, as I like to say, a universal truth. But one of the miracles of Bach is that he can take, and had in fact taken, texts for very disparate occasions and reuse the music, because for one thing, he knew that it would have a very short lifespan. I'm not saying that the text didn't inform the music, but that to me was a clue right away that even if you don't understand the text or believe what it's saying, the music will move you, will touch you. It is transcendent. There are these unfathomable elements about Bach just as a person. I mean, somebody who never went to university, never had, you know, the formal training in the traditional sense even of his time, never traveled very much. How did he do it? Where did this incredible gift, this spiritual element that touches us all in different ways, I think for somebody near the end of their life or at the beginning or any time in between, Bach is apart from everything else in the sense that it's something eternal. It's an eternal truth. You know, it's nice to have a few mysteries in life. And when you approach death, when you're at the end, you know, you think about a lot of things, but that composer and that music and that person, I don't know, I think of it as like a god. I mean, just something that has been with you on one level or another all through your life and will be with you in the life to come. I'm always so biased because I think we just have wonderful musicians all the way around, in the orchestra and the chorus and the soloists, because we live and breathe and bask in, not only in this music, but in this style as I perceive it. It's not even about historical accuracy, it's because then it really is, as Bach is the great leveler, it's all connected. And what I love about this ensemble, both in the orchestra and the chorus, is they really support each other. That helps us make great music in a much higher level, I think, because it's a real community.